All right, Home Skillet, so we got a pretty good video today. Got a couple things I'd like to talk about the S12. I've been working on it for all this time that I haven't been uploading YouTube videos. A lot of progress has been made, and you guys are gonna really enjoy this video. So let's just start talking about what I did. S12, still on jack stands. Got the wheels bolted on. That's nothing really important, but they do look fresh. The engine, let's start off with this. Last video, it wasn't running well. I thought I had valve lash. I thought I had all these things. And I figured out what the problem was. My boy John, he just copped the IS300. He told me to not say this, because you guys are gonna think I'm stupid, but we all make mistakes. And the reason why this engine was running how it was because the timing was off by 2 teeth. I could have swore I put it together flawlessly when I had it on the engine stand. It looked perfect, all the timing marks, but it might have jumped, you know, the first couple times me trying to start it. But other than that, I fixed it, took the head off, took the front cover off, reset the timing. Thing runs beautifully. No noise, no nothing. There's a lot of bugs flying around. But engine runs great. BC cams, it has the load, the bruh, 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 bruh. Oh, I can't wait to ride this thing. Well, drive it. Can't really ride a car. You can drive a car, though. But anyway, engine's on point. I'm going to start cleaning up this engine bay. Got a lot of trash everywhere. Going to start throwing things away. It's my garbage bag. But there is more things that have to be done. Oof, almost fell. Got to clean up all this wiring. For the most part, I got it a lot cleaner than what it was. Got to make some more grounds. Let me talk about this real quick. OG homies, remember, I took a trip up to Pennsylvania to visit my girlfriend at the time, and I looked underneath my hood, and my brake master was melted, and I believe that I have it somewhere over here. It might be, yeah, here it is. For those that didn't see that video, this is what I was running around with for months, and I never really peeped it until I broke down on like 78 West in Pennsylvania from overheating, and I saw this, and I'm just like, oh wow, this has to get changed. So I had that, took that off. Now I kind of rigged up my own remote master setup. I got two like barbed fittings to some hose. This hose is rated for power steering fluid because they didn't have the brake fluid hose, but I'm pretty sure this will work. It shouldn't eat through it because power steering, I would assume, is as corrosive, if that's the word, as brake fluid. So this is power steering line, barb fittings to a T-barb fitting to a single, and then I have this brake fluid master reservoir from a 2007 to 2000 and something Toyota Sienna. It might not be 7. It's something. But it's from a Toyota Sienna. Obviously cut this to length and figure out where I'm gonna mount this. My cousin was telling me cut this out to put it behind here, but I need to figure out another way. Cause my hood is spaced out, so I might be able to kind of just put it over here, but I have my clutch master that needs to be accessible. But if I mount this somewhere and it just, like, even if it's right here or something, if it clears the hood, that'll be fine. If I want to put, you know, clutch fluid or brake fluid in the clutch master, just remove it, fill it up, put it back, and that's that. But that's the setup. It'll work. Some of you guys might think that this is a bad idea, but I have no other choice because I'm not trying to ride around with a melted brake master reservoir anymore. Gotta still put clamps on this, but this is fine. There's no idling issues like I had in my first build with this car. I also have a power steering delete. There's no light. I don't have my light with me, but I'm gonna see if you guys can see this. I need to figure out where I put my light at. But I deleted my power steering. The whole pump as a whole. I don't know where I put that light. Dang. Alright, so I'm gonna illustrate with my hands, because you definitely can't see this with this light. So power steering pump mounts right here underneath the distributor. That's gone. There's nothing there. I have a single cam power steering, a single cam water pump pulley, and then a specific length. A belt. Single cam water pump pulley, belt. And this is a short belt that I looked up online. Some guy on a forum gave away the number. I found it in stock. It's a Continental belt. Gotta remember, I have the box somewhere around here. I think I might have thrown it out. But that belt allows you to actually run just the belt to the water pump pulley without, bypassing the power steering. So, and it's super tight too, because as you put the pump on, you can get the belt around the pulley, and then once you tighten up the pulley to the face of the water pump, it actually tightens the belt. And you can't see it, I wish you guys could see this, but it's stupid tight. Not crazy tight, but it's perfect tension. So I got that going on. Gotta put some more coolant in here. I have some coolant. I got my little Honda half radiator. I was running this for months, no problems. I got like 3 of these things just in case, because they're so cheap, like $100. Got that going on. I also had to relocate my battery. So I have this little positive jump post, positive power distribution post. I gotta clean up all these wires, starter wire. Ran power all the way back to the trunk, to the hatch, whatever it is. And this is my positive right here. Boom. I got extra, so this, don't pay attention to this. This is just extra. And then I have my negative. I gotta get a battery bracket for back here. Found some online, probably gonna look at a couple. And I have to mount this. Gotta find a nut that fits that hole. Sanded all around this to expose bare metal. And then once I have that, then I can put the negative on the negative. I'm not using this battery. This battery is shot. It's seen better days. It's gone. I want to get an Optima battery because those things are dope. Really good batteries. I'm also thinking about possibly getting new coilovers because I don't know if these are going to last very long. I mean, I don't see any fluid leaking out from them. I really hope that there's no fluid. I hope that they're not blown, but I need to probably get some new coils. But this ride height that I have going for me right now is pretty legit. I like how this is coming together. And the biggest thing that I started working on today, took my seats out. I don't know if you guys saw. Took the seats out. I'm going to clean the hell out of them. I'm going to eventually get blue racing seats. I don't know. I want like a Carl Bride, Corbel, whatever. I don't even know if I'm pronouncing those correctly. Corbo, whatever. But I'm going to clean these because I'm going to have to probably use them within the time as I look for seats. Do some like wet vac stuff because these are ridiculously dirty. Like, that's gross. But I want to keep the interior of the car blue. I found a molded carpet online, Federal Blue, that matches the color of my seats. And all the peeling of the leather on the interior, it just goes right in, boom. And probably some type of mounting on the edges to keep it down. But I found the carpet, $150-something with shipping. I might have to save up a check or two before I can get that, but that's definitely going to be a thing because I want this car to be clean and functional. I'm tired of, putting a car together for it to work. I did that with the first build. It was fun, but now that I have a better outlook on how I want this to be, like how I want this build to go, I really want this to be like a really clean car. The body's still clean. I got some rusting around somewhere. Some of you guys remember these are E46 BMW flares, literally cut right off the body, and I molded it to the body. Probably needs a little bit more Bondo because it's not that even, but it's pretty good for my skill level. So, the interior is going to get totally revamped. I'm going to put some lights and some tablets and stuff in there just because I want the car to be like a comfortable, fun car, cool to me. You know, big tablet in the middle, music, Bluetooth, maps, because I want this car to be like a travel car, I want daily travel. car with, you know, the GPS and the whole bell, all the bells and whistles of whatever. Another thing. This dash. Should I use this dash? Should I rip off all this leather and reupholster it? I can't even curse, but it's poop. Garbage. Junk. Straight junk. Oh, I need to salvage this Bosch Boost gauge. I want to make a custom dash. I'm set on that. I don't know how. I gotta get a big piece of metal. Make a custom dash with all custom gauges. And that's basically it. For the dash. I'm gonna have to take out all these freaking air boxes and fans and stuff, because I'm not going to use them. This car is not going to have heat or AC, because the fans didn't work before. I macked up the heck out of the harness, so I doubt I could even get it to work again. I probably could, but I'm not doing it. And that's it for that. This is going to be a... This interior is going to be pretty clean. I want it to be clean. It will be clean, because I'm going to put the work in to make it clean. The roof? Not so much. But the interior, or you not looking up, will be clean. And then I'm going to wrap the car, not white. I'm going to wrap the car a color that none of you could probably guess. And it's not going to be a flamboyant color. That's not me. It's going to be a nice, darker color. Towards the white spectrum of the color wheel, but it's definitely going to be, for those who watch Adventure Time, it's going to be a good build. It's going to come along well. I wish I could start this for you guys to prove to you that it runs absolutely amazing, but I don't have a battery. I don't feel like hooking that up and having that bubble and melt holes in the trunk with battery acid. But that's it for this video, Home Skills. In the comments below, let me know what you guys think about this build. Still gotta put a gasket on this. Oh, I still gotta get an O2. Well, still gotta get a wideband. Definitely a must. And I'm also going to save up some money and get a standalone ECU, because that's the only way that I can actually get this car running well. I need a standalone so I can get a really, really, really good in-depth tune. The chip tunes, they work, they're great, but if I'm going to do this car right, I gotta get a standalone. It's gonna cost some money, but it's gonna be worth it in the end. If I can find a used one, I'll use it, but I don't trust used electronics because I've had bad luck with used electronics. So I gotta get it brand new. It's like $800, but it'll friggin' be worth it at the end of the day. So, like and subscribe if you have never seen this channel. Share it, do something. I don't know what else to say, but in the comments below, what do you think about the dash? What do you think about the build, the interior? Comment how fresh these wheels are, and if you don't like them, I feel bad for your brain. And have a nice day.